responsible for the content of this advertising.
The WRDW News app on your Roku, Amazon Fire, or Apple TV store. Even if you cut the cord, you don't have to lose your local news. Just type in or search WRDW, and you've got your local news, First Alert weather, sports, and more for free. You have sagging floors?
Closed captioning for News 12 is brought to you by Kenneth Nugent. From the station that's on your side, this is News 12 at 6 o'clock.
Tonight, we're hearing from Augusta Mayor Hardy Davis in an exclusive interview.
You may remember almost 2 months ago, Davis gave a passionate speech claiming he had a plan to stop violent crime in our streets.
We are not going to rest in the city of Augusta with just our prayers, but we're going to pursue every effort of criminal activity, and we'll prosecute to the fullest extent of the law. It's not time for speeches and flowery words, but it's time for coordinated and collaborative action.
Hi, Craig Allison, live for us in the newsroom. And Craig, since that speech, we've really heard nothing about a plan. Did we get any more answers today? Well, Richard, for today, nothing specific but a preview of what's to come. He says next week his office will unveil his violence reduction plan, which will address housing, joblessness, and mental health, all centered on community engagement.
That's the hallmark of what we're going to talk about on next week from a violence reduction standpoint. You have to engage every sector of our community, but you've also got to engage the people who live in those communities.
While no timeline or funding was confirmed, Mayor Hardy Davis says we'll start with what we have, and he says his accomplishments have helped reduce crime already.
We've got more money in the bank than we've had in the last 30 years. Our reserves are substantial. We continue to make inroads where that's concerned. The amount of jobs, when I took office, unemployment was at 6%. We're at 3.2%.
He says this plan will push for introducing new laws, bringing in more affordable housing like tiny homes and more security like neighborhood crime watchers when you're away from home. But he still says the key to this is community engagement, which he says can solve more of Augusta's recent gang violence.
Number one, you live in a safe city. These are isolated events, isolated incidents, and the actors who commit these crimes, we know where they live. And there's a higher incidence of those communities of color who were hit the hardest during the pandemic. That's where you're seeing the majority of your criminal activity taking place.
With 3 months left in office, it could be his final legacy if it gets off the ground in time.
Everything rises and falls on leadership.
And despite what he has said about these isolated incidents not being a trend, we have numbers from the sheriff's office pointing Augusta to a potential 5-year high for murder and gun-related assaults. Also, according to CBS this year, Augusta's ranked the 32nd most dangerous city in the U.S. based off of murder rate.
Okay, thanks for asking those tough questions, Craig. After two shootings at local gangs last week and a double homicide Monday, we reached out to Augusta's District Attorney Jared Williams, and we asked about his thoughts on responsibility when it comes to keeping the community safe. Williams says public safety is a community responsibility and that we are all in this together. He goes on to say police and prosecutors are a response to crime, but parents, families, and the community as a whole have the power to prevent crimes. William says we have to watch and pray over our kids and keep them out of the streets. Laney High School will have to wait until next month to finish up their battle against Thompson after gunshots sent fans and players running for cover.
The next day, it was Josie High's homecoming tailgate party interrupted by gunfire, injuring two people there. Now, Laney High School preparing for their homecoming celebration tomorrow night. Will Rio is live from Laney High for us this evening with the school board voting this week to keep all those homecoming events in place. How's the team out there feeling about their safety?
Well, the overall feeling, Richard, is that it's going to be a safe and enjoyable weekend out here in Augusta. We got the band behind me out there practicing already, signs lining the street for all the classes to come and enjoy homecoming. But just last week, we saw a lot of people streaking out of the stadium, getting out of here, police lining the streets as there were shots that rang out right outside the stadium. Now, I had a chance to sit down and talk with head coach Ronnie Baker about everything that happened last weekend. He says that it's an avoidable situation and it's inexcusable that something like this would happen so close to home. He says that it's a priority that everyone is getting checked right here before they even get into the gates of the game. He also says that as long as law enforcement is active this weekend, it's going to be safe.
It was really hard to press it.
This video from Laney's football game last Friday night shows shows the chaotic scenes after gunfire erupts outside the stadium.
All the friends, family you had out here, the stadium was packed out, and all of a sudden you just heard shots fired. Everybody had to evacuate, get out the way, get into safety. Then you worry about everybody out here on the field. You don't know if they're going to be okay or not.
Then you hear the gunfire outside, and when you hear the gunfire, the first thing you think about is the safety of your players, the safety of the fans, the safety of your family.
Safety has been a top priority for the school board and law enforcement all week.
They have made steps to, you know, get the place, get our stadium safer. Security will be on point.
Specific safety plans are being kept tight-lipped, but the sheriff's office says they will have more manpower when people are coming and going to the games.
Because the kids on the field won't their parents in the stands, and we want our parents and we want our kids to feel safe while they're here.
Coach believes that if law enforcement shows up and stays active, everyone will have a fun and safe night.
I just want them to make sure that the whole game is protected. Law enforcement here to make sure we safe, keep everybody and their friends and family safe, so we can just have a good game, have a fun time at our homecoming.
And the school board and law enforcement have been saying all week that it is illegal to bring weapons, firearms, knives on school property. They have these signs posted both on the home and the visitor side. It says it is a felony to possess a weapon within a school safety zone. And they've also been preaching all week that if you do see something suspicious, that it is your duty, responsibility to report that. It's a community effort, like you heard Craig say as well. And we're just hoping for a safe and fun weekend here at Laney.
Hoping for a much quieter scene this weekend. Thanks for that, Will. Want to take a look outside over Beach Island.
Full forecast in just about 10 minutes.
New this evening, the Richmond County Sheriff's Office says they arrested one of their deputies today. They say David Wilburn is charged with family violence and simple battery. The Sheriff's Office says the arrest came after they responded to a domestic disturbance on Spring House Lane. Wilburn's resignation, that's effective immediately, and he was just hired over 6 weeks ago. A McCormick County deputy, also in jail, charged with attempted murder and misconduct of a public officer. Sled says he is 44-year-old Jason Irwin, and authorities say he was driving his patrol car drunk Wednesday night and rammed into another car. They say he also threatened to shoot the victims and fired a shotgun in the air. According to arrest warrants, Irwin admitted to drinking before the encounter and also told authorities he had a flask of bourbon with him on the scene. We've reached out for his mugshot. We have not gotten that yet.
Thousands flowing into Augusta this weekend for the Ironman competition. Athletes and tens of thousands of spectators really all over the world are coming to town, many of them already here. And the good news is this brand new 5th Street pedestrian bridge opening up officially tomorrow morning. The soft opening's tonight, so you can catch the swimmers right down there below in the Savannah River as they splash off Sunday morning. Maria Sellers live for us downtown, showing us all the buzz and preparation for this weekend's Ironman events.
Well, I'm here at the Marriott Convention Center where people have been coming in, getting those registration packets for Ironman. But the preparations are happening all across the city. I spoke to a local bike shop owner and athletes who tell me what goes into preparing for Sunday's race. Andy Jordan's bike warehouse plays a key role in getting racers ready.
We have folks that have made appointments many months in advance to get their bikes assembled by us. So they either have the bike shipped to us or they fly with the bike, bring it in a box or case.
The race doesn't happen for another 2 days, but the preparations start early.
It takes a lot of time, a lot of effort to get ready for one of these events. It's pretty neat being able to help these folks out.
Bikes are not the only thing that need to be prepared. The athletes do too.
But we went and checked out the bike route because that's important to us. We also want to try the water, try our wetsuits, try goggles, make sure everything is working for race day.
But training starts well before race weekend.
Every day we wake up at 4 in the morning, and on the weekends we do our long rides, which are a lot of hours.
Hernandez says she hopes the work pays off as she aims to beat her personal record.
So I'll be giving all my heart and soul on the race that Sunday.
For Jordan, playing a small role in helping people reach their goals is what it's all about.
I think the big benefit is just seeing people achieve the goal that they set out to achieve.
And there will be more people expected in this area tomorrow coming and getting those packets for Ironman. Jordan says they too anticipate a pretty big crowd.
Maria. Thanks very much for the live update from downtown. Fort Gordon's Commanding General Paul Stanton joining me this week for a one-on-one conversation. We talked about a lot of things, including his plans to improve the lives of soldiers here at Fort Gordon.
We're undergoing the new campus, as we discussed, but it's not the only construction we have ongoing. We're also building new barracks. We're building new warrior restaurants where our soldiers eat, new child development centers. We're looking to revitalize, you mentioned housing earlier. We have a plan to break ground on 76 new homes in October.
General Paul Stanton, Commanding General of Fort Gordon. You can catch the entire interview Sunday morning on News 12 and on WRDW.com after that. Just look for the one-on-one tab.
Still to come, a former Bulldog and Super Bowl champion leading and reading with the kids in Burke County today. His message on the power of words coming up.
And beautiful weather in store for our weekend forecast, but heading into next week, we possibly could be impacted by Tropical Depression 9. Have more on this system just after the break. $5 meal deal. You've earned it.
A former Georgia Bulldog making his way to Burke County to set the example for students there. Malcolm Mitchell giving away copies of his new book, Hey Georgia. He also read to the kids, teaching them the importance of learning in the classroom. Mitchell has a lot of accolades on the gridiron, a Super Bowl championship with the Patriots back in 2017. But he says his career as an author is really helping him touch even more lives.
No one's born a reader. Just how you learn to play sports, you have to learn to read. And really empowering children to overcome maybe some challenges with reading, to me, is the first step in getting them to interact with it in a way that would allow it to empower their life.
Such a great role model. He always has been on and off the field, former Georgia Bulldog, and love to see him continuing to do good.
Spreading the word about reading, and that is great to see. We wish him big success with his latest book.
Yeah, I will definitely be picking up a copy. Hey, Georgia.
Hey, Riley, let's talk about Georgia.
Mostly past the weekend, but no radar forecast through the weekend, and most of next week looks dry as well.
Tonight's homecoming for the 3-1 Academy of Richmond County Musketeers. Our Under the Lights coverage continues right after this break.
The Live Mic. News 12 Under the Lights, powered by Sig Cox.
Good evening, everyone. It's Friday, and we've got some high school football to talk about. So let's continue our Under the Lights coverage by checking in with the Academy of Richmond County Musketeers, who are absolutely on fire right now. News 12's Alyssa Lyon joins us now from the high school as the Musketeers prepare for their homecoming showdown with Lincoln County.
Yeah, these Musketeers are making a new name for themselves this season. This was a region title team back in 2020. They lost a lot of senior playmakers then, and it showed. They went 2-8 last year, and now under a new head coach, they are creating a new identity under head coach David Salmon. The Musketeers have won 3 of their last 4, all 3 of those coming in a string of to tonight's homecoming, and that's due in part to this team's motto. Forget about it. Play the next down. Think about the next game. To Salmon's, how you practice is how you play. The defense has been an exceptional part of this team's working philosophy, allowing just 4 points per game over the last 3.
All sorts of practice. I've been here for 5 years. They are probably the best practice group we've ever had. They love hitting. They love going at each other and competing. And that was my big thing, is how can we make practice as competitive as possible? Because that's where you ball games. You don't win with a crowd in the stand. You win out there on the practice field and buying into practice and buying into being competitive.
Now, after talking to Salmons and other players on this team, the really key to the game here is how well the defensive line will set the tone and set it early and be able to contain the Red Devils' run game, especially with Samaj Jenkins on the ground.